Hello and welcome to PDFSupply.com. Today we're going to be testing a RX3i analog input card, 6-channel. This is an IC695ALG106. A couple things about it: as you can see, it has the high density terminal, and the field status that I have right now, the module OK light is blinking green, and I have a red light on the terminal block. So what I want to do is, just for in case you guys don't know, this lever attaches the terminal block to the unit itself, and once it makes contact, physical contact, when you put the lever in the most upright position, the terminal block will turn green, this LED. Okay, you want to make sure that that's green, and you want to make sure your module OK light is blinking green. If it isn't blinking green, if you don't have a light on there at all, then there's something more wrong with this unit. It will need replacement or repair. Okay, we'll talk about that later. Now, as far as testing the unit, a couple things that you guys need to know. It does not need any external power source. There are 6 inputs. The inputs are only on the left-hand side of the terminal. Those are screws number 1 through 18. Okay. Now, the way that the screws are set up is that the voltage and the return, or the common, would be on the nearest 2 screws to each other. So in this particular case, the common is always the lowest most screw out of the 3 in each channel. That means that the middle screw, in this particular case, screw number 2, will be voltage. Similarly, down below, if the return is number 6, then the voltage will be number 5. And the top screw, or the furthest most screw, in this case 3 and 1, the current measurement, current in milliamps, is going to be the top screw. Okay, so keep that in mind when you guys are probing these terminals, that you make sure that you know the difference between the voltage and the current, and how to measure it and where to measure it. Okay, so the next step is to go into Proficy Machine Edition, is the software that I'm using. All right. And once you guys are in there, you take a look at my hardware configuration. I'm on the right-hand side of my navigator bar, if you follow my arrow. Now, the power supply and the CPU are using the first 4 slots, as they use 2 slots apiece. That leaves me with the next available slot of slot 4. I can right-click on that or double-click on it, select Add Module, go to Analog Input. And what I'm looking for, again, is the IC695ALG106. Okay, 6-channel isolated analog input. Okay. And a few things about the configuration here that are really important. The first thing that's important, of course, is the reference address, where we're going to look to see our values. It starts at analog input 0001. And it's 6 channels long. Then we go to channel 1 to begin with. And we want to enable it by clicking on where it says disabled, voltage or current. The default setting will be voltage from negative 10 to 10 volts. And the value we're going to use for this particular test is going to be 16-bit integer. So we'll stick with the 0 to 10 volt, or negative to 10 volt, but we're going to use voltage DC for our first test, and then I'll show you guys how we switch over and test current. So just make sure that these are all changed over. Okay, once they are, we're going to select the lightning bolt icon, which is to connect up to the processor. Once we make connection to the processor, try that one more time. Once we do make connection to the processor, we're going to hit the green handprint once that lights up. There we go. All right, now this toggles us into programmer mode. If you look down below at our status bar, you guys should be the same here. Programmer mode Stop disabled. The stop disabled refers to our outputs are disabled, and the configuration and logic are not equal. That's because the processor was doing a different task, maybe just a slightly different task, before we've asked it to test this. So what we want to do in that case, before we go any further, go to target, online commands, clear. We're just going to clear the controller and I/O fault table because we're faulted. We're doing something slightly different than what it did before. And if you don't do this, you're going to get hung up when we go to do the download. All right, so now we're ready to download. Click on the download icon. And it's going to tell you there's a build in progress. The first thing it's going to ask us is what exactly do we want to download to the controller? All right, in this particular case, just for a simple test, it's hardware configuration in motion and logic. We don't want to write anything to permanent flash memory or anything else. That's not really important for what we're doing here. The test, again, is just on the ability for this analog input to work properly, or a test if it isn't working properly. Now, while this is loading up, I just want to tell you guys a couple things that I have here for test fixtures is... I'm using a 3-volt memory battery that I've attached positive and negative leads to, and that'll allow me to probe my voltage DC terminals and get a response. And what I'm hoping to see in my responses is a stable, steady response and consistent. They're all configured and scaled the exact same way, so I should get the same reading on every channel without any movement. So once this is done, we're going to enable our outputs. We're going to drop down to our default tables. Analog input is what we want. And when that table is open, you're going to see some values that read there initially. As I said before, that we're set up, if you look, for negative 10 volts. So we're going to get this negative 10,000 value. That's fine. And we're going to probe each channel as per the wiring diagram. And if you guys take a look at my table when it changes, I'm going to attach my negative lead to terminal 3 and my positive lead to terminal 2, the nearest most two connections. And then I'm going to go to 5 and 6. Again, if you notice, my numbers are exactly the same. They're very, very stable. 8 and 9. I'm on channel 3. 11 and 12. That's channel 4, 14 and 15, 17 and 18. If you look at the second line of values, so it's very consistent, very stable. So I'm sure that the voltage end of this is working. So what we're going to do at this point is stop the controller, go back to our ALG106, starting with channel 1, we're going to drop down this menu. We're going to ask it to test 4 to 20 milliamps, or you guys could use 0 to 20 milliamps, doesn't really matter, as long as we're testing the current measurement in milliamps on this particular input module is what we want to do. We want to make sure that all the channels are working and all the reading capabilities are working. All right, so go to target. Again, we're asking it to do something slightly different. That's why it's going to say down below, configuration is not equal. Because even though it's the same module, we're asking it to do something just a little bit different. We're going to clear that fault, that not equal fault, and select OK. And tell it it's OK to change, download and run. Same exact procedure. When we get to the point where it asks us what we want to download, just configuration, motion, and logic. Okay, yes. Again, that's just the first two selections, none of the other ones. Now, for this particular test, you're going to need a 0 to 20 or a 4 to 20 milliamp output generator, and I have such a thing. It's you guys can't see what I have on the video, but it's just a box that's labeled that it's 4 to 20 milliamp output. It's a current generator. and I have an adjustable dial on it. Now that's going to be important because what we find usually is that analog inputs typically fail at full value. So in other words, no matter what value I probe the channel with, I probe the terminals with, it will immediately go to its full value of 32,767. Now that's not every time it fails. Sometimes it doesn't give me a reading at all if it fails. But it's something that you guys want to keep in mind, okay? So we're going to enable the outputs. We're going to go back to our input table. And I'm going to probe this so that you guys can see what the readings look like. I'm not going to go through every channel. I'll go through a couple. Okay, so per our scaling, approximately 20,000 would be 20 milliamps. Okay, so 19,939, I'm satisfied with that. It's almost completely stable. Now, if I dial down the value, I can see that there's range and resolution to this card. It's seeing that it's getting less milliamps, and it's showing the values of those less milliamps. Okay, so that channel's good. If it was stuck at the 20,000 or the 19,949, that'd be a problem. It needs to be able to detect the milliamps going up and down. Okay, now we're on channel two. Same thing, I'm gonna show you guys. I got the same reading as the first channel, and I'm gonna go down and back up. Okay, that's all I'm gonna give you for that. So just keep in mind, make sure that you check the range of resolution, make sure that the module is capable of detecting upward and downward throughout those values. Okay, so to recap, if the voltage or the milliamp is unstable, or if it fails at full value, which you guys know how to test that now, any of those things could be a problem. If the module OK light doesn't come on, you're pretty much dead in the water from the get-go. And that would mean, again, that the module needs replacement or repair. So these are modules that we do repair here at PDF Supply. We offer exchange programs, new and remanufactured products. So if that's something that you need or interests you, please see us at pdfsupply.com. Thank you.